Hello everyone. So I hope everyone is doing great. And if you are wanted to know like what is the interview process at Barclays or what kind of interview questions you can brush up before taking up an interview with Barclays, then this video is for you. In this video, I'll be sharing my interview process that I have underwent at Barclays, and at the same time, I'll be sharing the interview questions that I have encountered in the interview. So coming to the interview process, so there were 2 technical rounds and followed by 1 manager round, and after that I got a call from HR. So before getting into the interview questions things, I would like to give a quick discussion about on what all technologies the interview process has happened. So this basically, they were looking out for a full stack developer, and they were looking out for the technologies like Angular in the front end, and coming to the back end technologies, they were looking out for someone who is good at Java, Spring Boot, MongoDB, REST. So these were the technologies that on which the questions were asked to me. So before getting into the questions, I would like to give a quick introduction of ourselves, like who are we and what we do. So we are a bunch of software engineers who are attending the interviews at different MNCs and sharing the interview experiences through these videos. So you can see on the screen, like these all are MNCs of which we have already shared the interview experiences and interview questions. You can visit our channel and you can find the same videos, and in the description link as well you can find the links to different interview experiences. If you haven't subscribed us, you feel free to subscribe us, or if you want to contribute us, you can always reach us out at the below email address which is given in the description as well. So that was about ourselves and the interview process. So coming to the interview questions, so firstly I will be discussing about the interview questions that were asked as part of front end technologies. So basically, they were looking out for a guy who was very good at basics of JavaScript and Angular. So here are the questions. So the first question was, tell me the difference between local storage and session storage. So I have explained him like this. So local storage and session storage are the web storage objects. Session storage is destroyed once the user closes the browser, whereas local storage stores the data with no expiration date. The session storage object is equal to the local storage object, except that it stores the data for one session only. So this was the answer which I have given. So the next question was the difference between TypeScript and JavaScript. So the key difference is, JavaScript is a scripting language which helps you create interactive web pages, whereas TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript. TypeScript code needs to be compiled, while JavaScript code does not need to compile. TypeScript supports a feature of prototyping, while JavaScript doesn't support this feature. So this was the answer which I have given. You can have your own answer or you can follow the same answer. Then they have asked the differences between var and let. So I hope this is a very basic question and most of us might be knowing, but still I would like to give the answer which I have given. Like var and let are both used for variable declaration in JavaScript, but the difference is that var is function scoped and let is block scoped. So this is the short answer which I would like to give. So coming to the next question, it was the difference between undefined and null. So undefined means a variable has been declared but has not yet been assigned a value, whereas null is an assignment value. So coming to the next question, explain the various features of Angular. So at that moment, what all features I remembered, I have explained him like Angular supports cross platform, high speed and optimum performance, Angular MVC architecture, efficient two-way binding, less code framework, Angular CLI. So these were the few features which I have explained in the interview. And coming to the next question, it was about the navigation thing. So he asked me to write and explain and navigate in between different routes in Angular. So I was given a pen and paper. So on a plain paper, I was asked to write the code, like a basic code of that, how routing works in Angular. So I have explained him the same. And coming to the next question, how do observables differ from promises? So I have answered this in this way. As soon as a promise is made, the execution takes place. However, this is not the same case with observables because they are a bit lazy. This means that nothing happens until a subscription is made. So that was the answer which I have given. Coming to the next question, it was about, so I have said the same here as well. So coming to the next question, explain directives in Angular. So directives are nothing but is a JS class which is declared as @directive. We have 3 different directives in Angular. and they are component directives, structural directives and attribute directives. So coming to the component directives, these form the main class with having details of how the component should be processed. Coming to the structural directive, they are ng-if and ng-for. And coming to the attribute directives were changing the look and behavior of the DOM element. So this was about the directive things. And the next question was explain about building blocks of Angular. So these are the building blocks of Angular, like modules, component, templates, metadata, data binding, directives, services, DI or dependency injection. So these are the main building blocks of Angular. And the next question was about the data binding, like what is data binding and how many ways it can be done. So data binding is one of the most powerful and important features in any software development language. In Angular, it is automatic and instantiate synchronization between model and view. So coming to the different ways, it can be done through property binding, event binding and two-way binding. So these were the questions that were asked me as part of my Angular questions, which was mostly in the first round of the interview. And in the next sections, I will be discussing about the interview questions of that were asked me on Java, Spring Boot, MongoDB, REST. So stay tuned for that as well. So it is not the end. So coming to the backend interview questions. So the first question was, explain how do you create a REST service in Spring Boot and how do you integrate it with different components? So while I was explaining about the entire process, there were n number of questions that he was asking, that like the interviewer was asking me. So be prepared for that as well, to face the counter questions, like why are you choosing certain specific things in achieving those things. So these kind of questions were asked me. So please be confident here when you are explaining the things to him. So coming to the next question, it was about the class creation. I believe create your own ArrayList class. So a pen and paper was given to me again. So I started explaining him the, like I was writing the code and I was explaining him the process of how can we create our own custom ArrayList class. So while I was explaining him, there were n number of questions again, like lot of cross questions he was asking me, like why have you chosen this, why can't we do these, and all such kind of questions were asked to me. So that was about the ArrayList class. So the next question is like we actually have used MongoDB in few of my applications. So based on that, he asked me questions like, why do you went for MongoDB? What all advantages it adds to your project? And there were n number of questions on that as well. Like how do you integrate it with Spring Boot? What dependencies you need and how can you not achieve the same thing that you are achieving it through JPS. So that was the first question. And coming to the next question, he was asking me the differences between MongoDB and SQL. So I tried to explain here. So although MongoDB and MySQL are both free and open source databases, there is a lot of difference between them in the terms of data representation, relationship, transaction, query data, schema design and definition, performance, speed. There are n number of differences. So few I remembered and have explained in the same in detail. So this was about the differences between MongoDB and MySQL. Then he asked me a different question. To be honest, I was not aware of this question, like does MongoDB need a lot of RAM? So I have later on googled this question and I said the answer that I came up with was no, there is no need a lot of RAM to run MongoDB. It can be run even on small amount of RAM because it dynamically allocates and deallocates RAM according to the requirement of the process. So this was about the RAM. So next was about what is sharding in MongoDB. So I have tried to explain here in MongoDB, sharding is a procedure of data storing records across multiple machines. It is a MongoDB approach to meet the demands of data growth. It creates horizontal partition of data in a database or search engine. Each partition is referred as shard or database shard. So next thing was a bit tricky thing, like how can you achieve primary key a foreign key relationship in MongoDB. So by default, Mongo does not support such primary key foreign key relationships. However, we can achieve this concept by embedding one document inside another. For example, like an address document can be embedded inside a customer document. So in this way we can achieve, but there is no directly foreign key primary key relationship in MongoDB. So the next question was, what are the disadvantages of MongoDB? So everything has its own advantages and disadvantages. So coming to the MongoDB disadvantages, MongoDB is only ideal for implementing things like analytics, caching, where impact of small data loss is negligible. In MongoDB, it is difficult to represent relationships between data, so you end up doing that manually by creating another table to represent the relationship between rows in two or more tables. So these were the disadvantages of MongoDB which I felt. So the next question was on how to make one service call from another. So I have explained this him, like we can make use of REST template and exchange method of that. By using that, we can communicate from one service to another service. So the next question was a bit interesting thing. So the question was, one REST service is dependent on other service, which is taking long time. How do you analyze and fix that issue? So it was a tricky question, to be honest, and I was trying to explain in other ways. So both the services are in my hand, like the code of both the services in my hand. So I'll debug the code, like which process exactly taking lot of time, and I'll try to fix it. And when he said like we don't have the code control on the third party service, how do you fix it? So I said him like we'll make asynchronous calls so that it runs in the backend but doesn't have that much impact on our code. So to be honest, he was a bit okay on this question. He was not completely satisfied with the answer that I gave him. So the coming to the next question, how to call a SOAP service from a REST service. So I have worked a lot on such kind of scenarios like calling a SOAP service from a REST service. So I was pretty much easy for me to answer this question here. So the next question was about the caching thing, like how does caching work in your application. So in detail, I have explained the entire thing, like how we have designed the caching and up to how much time we hold that cache in our application. So he was a bit satisfied there also. So next coming question was like, explain what is dependency injection or DI with an example. So I was well prepared for this type of questions, and it was very easy for me to explain the questions. Coming to the next question was, what is Spring Boot? So explaining the entire thing of what is Spring Boot, why it came into picture, and what all advantages and disadvantages it brings with it. So the next question was, create a sample Spring Boot project with all the layers and proper exceptional handling. So he was expecting me to write a code which is production ready. This question was asked me in the second round. So majorly on this question only the entire second round went on, like how do I create a sample Spring Boot project with all the complete neat layers, and how those layers communicate with each other with proper exceptional handling. So the next question was, explain the different types of scopes supported by Spring. So there are four scopes, like singleton, prototype, request, session, and global session. So I have explained them in detail, those things. So then there was one more tricky question, like while writing a code, to what you will give more importance, performance or memory management. So this is one more tricky interview questions, I would say. To be honest, I said like I would give importance to both, because if one fails, the application will fail. So I will write a code in such a way that by giving both the importance to both the things, like performance and memory management. Usually we run sonar things and Veracode scans to catch hold of these things. So I have said him the same thing. So these were the questions that were asked to me in my technical rounds. In the next section, I'll be sharing you the manager round interview questions. So to be honest, he was a very good guy, like very professional way he was handling the interview, and very calmly he was listening to me as well, like what all things I am saying. Like, so let us discuss like what questions he asked me. So he asked me, the first question was like, can you describe a work instance in which you messed up? So I have explained him like there are a number of times we get messed up, because everybody has their own way of coding the things. So I have said him like what all the instances that I have encountered and how I have resolved it later on. So he was there was a few counter questions as well here, which I have explained him in a different way. Then the next question was like, how would your current manager describe you? So to be honestly, I have faked here few things, like I am having a very good impact and so things. I have talked about my previous year rating, what all feedback they gave me, and all those things. So next question was like, this was a bit a tricky question. Like, assuming that you are selected, what will be your strategy for next 30 days? So I have explained him like, firstly, I would like to get the KTs, and once I get KTs, I'll try to look up the things like in what all ways I can implement my experience into this project and see that improve the performance of the application or more customer interactive or client interactivity here. So it was a bit, what can I say, happy with the answer. So the next question here is there was, is there any particular kind of person you cannot work with? So to be honest, I don't feel that I cannot work with any person. I can work with any person, no matter how bad he is, what type of attitude he is. Because when I get into the work, I just concentrate on the work instead of individual person. So I have said him the same thing. Next question was about the salary. What kind of a salary you are looking for? So I have explained him like what is the salary I was looking out for. So I have given him a number. So he said, okay, the HR will get back to you. And then later on, I got a call from HR, and this were the manager round questions that I have encountered. So later on, I got a call from HR where I got a bit negotiation with the package there. And finally, an offer was released to me. So coming to the feedback of the interview, I would say it was, I have very positive impact on the positive feedback I would give, because everywhere the interviewers were very professional, polite, like they were helping out us whenever, like they were helping me out like whenever I was stuck a bit here and there. So I would say it was overall a very good interview process. And coming to the salary offer, so the salary offer was 15 lakhs per annum. So, and most important thing I forgot to mention here, like the experience level of this interview was 6.5 years. So for that level of year, for 6.5 years of experience, 15 lakhs package is a good amount, I feel, and I have accepted the offer as well. And these were the interview questions, interview process, and there were a few questions, I would say, like general questions, like explain about your roles and responsibilities, project architecture, how do you rate yourself in different technologies. And there were few other Java interview questions, which are very common in every interview. So those type of questions I haven't shared here, believing me that everybody would be aware of those questions. So with that, I would like to conclude the interview process and interview experience of Barclays here. So please do subscribe, share, like, comment, feedback in the comment section, whether you like this interview, whether this interview helped you or not. And with this, I would like to thank you once again for watching the video, and I'll be stopping the recording here.